bro. Oh wait. Okay.
For the beehive.
No. Ow. My body.
All and pick up the frog, then use it on the pitcher.
Dang it. Come on. So which one do we dump to use, look, we get rid of that, yeah? Slash all, baby. Okay. Now, if we... Okay, check this out. If we do steel as well with that, that's gonna be dirty. That's gonna be very dirty, so... Slash all. Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
Alright. Run past first insect, grab second one instead. Bring in the pigeon in the beginning, then grab the first insect and then use it on the first, then you'll launch towards stamen.
Alright. Test out the slash all. It didn't steal as well.
Maybe it doesn't work with that combination.
Maybe it doesn't work with that combination. I'll have to check it later.
Use the dragon horn, dragon fang.
Oh, come on.
To use one.
Good. left and up the trunk.
Follow the branch around, then use the lower knot here to reach the stamen and... Okay. Pipe. Return to where you first entered this screen and head down this time. Frog, launch right, and return to the third screen. Yeah. Gimme. Okay, wait for him to launch me. Oh, boss. Turn the treetops, and this time make your way to the center tree, right of where you enter, and then run down the trunk. Okay. Down. use the insect on the pitcher plant to the right. Then jump to the second one and grab the beehive. I'm running away from these enemies, they shit me. Again. Okay. This one's a weird one. Okay. Oh, I see. One of the only weapons to have triple material growth. Depending on the situation,
Might want to use that one.
But I'd rather Ragnarok, to be honest with you.
I will equip it, just to show you what it looks like though. I'm pretty sure it's one of the better looking swords in the game. I could be wrong. Cleaned out the ancient forest. Come on. I just want to show off the sword.
Please let me show off the sword.
Different. Let's put the better sword, in my opinion, back on. Must have been that one, surely. I'll check. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's fine. Okay. So we've gotten everything with the black chocobo. We could try to win 10 in a row. But I mean, you know. I would like to see how he does at the golden saucer. I would like to see that.
What's the requirements for killing the diamond weapon though? I might be able to do it now. How many achievements have we unlocked now?
79. Yeah, complete first phase of ultimate weapon fight in one battle. And that one is a 10-point achievement? Okay, so... is this one a particularly difficult one? Complete first phase in one battle. So, like...
and what kind of enemy are we talking about here? Does have an enemy skill that we would like.
Okay. But we can get it on enemies in the Northern Crater, so that's fine. Okay. I'm not too worried about, like... okay.
Reflect Ring. Where can we get Reflect Rings? Oh. You can only get it once. Well, twice. Once from Genova Death, who drops it. And then, you can steal them from Ultimate Weapon. And this is repeatable, because Ultimate Weapon flies away. Interesting. It has 100,000 HP. Okay. Requirements for this. I don't care about Reflect Ring, I'm gonna be honest with you. Do not care. Because once the reflect spell goes, then it's essentially a useless accessory. Yeah, limb breaks, Ultima, high-end summons. I'm not sure if I can get it in one battle though. I can get in one battle. Maybe with the Omnislash. I think it's gonna be easier for me to try to get a gold chocobo, to be honest with you, to get the nuts of the round material. I truly believe that, so we'll do some more chocobo racing, that's fine. Now that I've taken him out of the stable though, will he be selectable? So I better just drop a save. It'll be good to clap Joe. It'll be good. I can finally fight him mano a mano with a bird that's equally as gassed up. Probably more gassed up. Let's be honest. Plan will be get the Blackbird to S class, and then try to find a wonderful chocobo near the Ice Village. Grab that thing, get that thing to S class, or to A class, probably to A class, and then breed them two together to get the gold chocobo to get the Knights of the Round. That's going to be, honestly, the only way that I can foresee me doing the achievement for this one. Got Barret's Limit Break as well. That one's fairly nasty. I finally got Omnislash.
Yeah, my boy Zoro. My guilty far. Yep. Alright, let's... 1-3-1, that's what we're talking about right there. Absolutely juiced. Juiced. Alright, let's see how ridiculous this bird can be. What a disgusting chicken. What a disgusting chicken. They should immediately put this bird in S-Class. I mean, come on. It's unfair to the other chickens. Well, what can I say? And I can't press start and continue on until the other birds finish. How on earth am I going to reduce ultimate weapon? How am I going to clap it in one battle when it's got 100,000 HP? I can't see it happening without Knights of the Round. It has no weaknesses either. That one's a tough one. It's gonna have to be Cloud with the Honor Slash, Barret probably with the Catastrophe, and who else has got a good one? No one else has like multiple, but then again I haven't checked what Sid's High Wind's like. Oh, Yuffie has got a multiple, I believe. So we could do that, I guess. There we go. Good girl, Tifa. Bye-bye. 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 Gotta go fast. Gotta go real fast. I wonder how fast the gold choker is going to be, especially when I give it like 900 silver screens. It's going to be glorious. Easy clap. What other things can I do with ultimate weapon then? Because what I'd rather do is get the achievement, but then slowly like get two more reflect rings. Because that'd be useful. Possibly. Cloud, though. Cloud with Ragnarok. With an Omnislash. And then we come in with the other Limit Breaks, and then with Knights of the Round. It's probably going to cave its asshole in, let's be honest. And I'm at a level where it's like, yeah, this will probably work. Imagine Tifa doing the remake and the Jizzle. Yeah. I'm guessing it's going to happen. I really do hope...